Welcome to Ghost Rider Hockey on Kootenai Cable. Tonight, the Bismarck Bobcats, and fifth meeting of the season between these two teams, but just like Billings, the Riders have yet to get a win against the Bobcats.
Yeah, again, as we made those costly mistakes at the beginning of the year, one was in our own arena and eventually cost us, but this is a new team now. Two of the players that are on our team, Bobcats haven't seen.
Brent? Probably more than a couple. I don't think they've seen Jeremy Robinson. Oh, yeah, they would have.
Yeah, they would have.
Not at home, anyway.
Popovich and Kyle Shane, they haven't seen either. So I think it's going to be a physical game. Bismarck is separated above us by 3 points. So this is a costly game for us. We need it. And I think Kimberly has 52 points.
They're six up, I think.
Yeah. So this is a big game for just for even three positions, because tomorrow's going to change again.
I thought what you were saying was, since that game we lost on home ice, the players they haven't seen. But I know what you mean now. But I wanted to talk about that game. That was one of the first games. We were 1-0 when we met Bismarck, and we lost that game with 20 seconds left, and that started a string of losses in the last couple of minutes. They got over that hump. A loss at the Showcase in Bozeman and two losses. I don't like to use nasty words when I talk about this team, but they were brutal losses in Bismarck.
Yeah.
They got scored on early, same as the Minot situation. They got scored on early, but when Minot came here, we turned that around and scored on them both nights, 2-goal and a 3-goal lead.
Yeah, again, it was just those costly mistakes. And the thing, like you said, it was mental errors. And what we've been battling all year was inconsistency. We come out hard against, a fantastic game against Great Falls, for example. And then we let down and lose to a team like Bozeman, which is a highly improved team. But when you get opportunities, especially in your own arena, you have to get those 2 points because they're major, and you want to set that example for the future coming into the playoffs, that when they come into the arena, it's going to be a hard fought.
I think it's a mental hurdle as well. If we do end up facing Bismarck anywhere in the playoffs, it's unlikely we'll see them in the first round, just the way things are starting to shape up now. But the season's not over yet, so that may not be true. But same with Billings and Bismarck, the only two teams left Fernie hasn't beaten. It's a psychological thing. If they face either one of those teams, it'll be nice to know that they beat them. And Fernie is still a lot tougher in their barn than they are in Bismarck, so I expect a lot better effort than we saw in Bismarck.
Well, definitely, like how we played against Minot, for example, last weekend. We beat Bozeman on Friday's game. We slacked off, let in a shorthanded goal, and it cost us. And then we came right back in and to beat Minot right in our arena in the last game of that three-game set. It's a big improvement. It's a big plus. And the players have to remember that when we come out to play, they have to be aggressive. Get that forecheck going in there. Jonesy will start rotating the lines. People say, well, he doesn't play all of his lines enough. Sure he does. If you watch the team in effect, not everybody plays their top four lines. There's always a top two to three lines, and that's always happens. We have home ice advantage. We match it all the time. You have to. You never want to put out a fourth line against a number one line unless you want to aggressively forecheck them. So, again, it's going to be hard fought. Hard work is going to win this game.
Looking at their goaltending before I came here, while looking on the internet at some stats, their goaltending is not strong.
No.
That might be their weak link here, and we did see that in Bismarck. I mean, the games were, well, one of them, I think they shut us out in one of them. That was that goaltender's first game, and they did shut us out in the one game. But besides that, Bismarck has had to win some high-scoring games, so we'll see how that plays out tonight and see if the goaltending lets the Bobcats down. But last week, Minot was supposed to have outstanding goaltending, and we got to both goaltenders.
Yeah, you said it. Again, Bismarck, when they first came in at the beginning of the year, and I checked it on the webpage, they considered Fernie not even a threat, not even a challenge for the Bourne Cup this year. They said we lacked intensity, they said we lacked size, and they also said that we lacked in goal scoring and as well as goaltending. Well, if you look at Bismarck, they're the most disappointing team in the league. Why? They pull in veterans like the Fernie Ghost Riders did last year, and I'm talking 20-year-olds. Over half of the team was 20-year-olds, and what they did, they started losing. What did they start doing? They moved 9 players in and out of their roster. You're not going to win a championship like that. It's too difficult. Sure, they brought in some nice players and stuff, but again, it's chemistry, and I believe that firmly. If you can't have a proper gel inside the team, you got big problems.
One player they got to watch out for tonight, obviously, Alex Perez. Player of the week in the AWHL, I believe, in week one of the year. He had a good start to the year. He started to fall off a little bit, but him being their best player. Having said that, Ryan Wiggins is the guy who's done the most damage against us this year, 7 points in 4 games. So who do you focus on? I wouldn't be surprised to see Wiggins and Perez out there together. So it's going to be a matter of, and Bismarck is almost a one-line team as well. They're not quite. They've got a good couple. Their top two lines are good, but their top line is far far superior to their second line. And in our case, they got two pretty good, you know, who's number one and who's number two. It's kind of like line one and line 1A for us, whereas between those two, there is a distinction between line one and two.
Definitely, and the quickest way to neutralize players like that, you're never going to stop them. But the thing is, like we did against Great Falls and Kiskis and Dwyer and Moe, we hit them, and we hit them hard. It wasn't one just little tap out there on the ice. It was a continuous, every chance they got touched with the puck, they got hit. And that's what the Riders are going to have to do on this ice against Wiggins Wiggins and the other gun.
Oh, that's Perez.
Perez. He tagged them hard. They're going to be looking over the shoulder, and they won't be able to make those good key plays. And again, be physical. Hit them when you got the chance. Make them look over your shoulder.
Let's forget all about who's in town tonight for 1 second and just talk about the fact that every time these guys get to 500, they did go two games above 500. Then they went on a bit of a slide, and now they've been up and down to 500 and below. It'd be really nice to see these guys put together a few wins in a row, especially going into that trip with Bozeman and Billings back-to-back. Yeah. They got to get some confidence going into that trip, get themselves over the 500 mark. I don't know if that's a mental hump or not. I keep being told it's not, but just by appearances, you might think, well, maybe it is a little bit. I don't think the players sit in the locker room and go, oh, no, we're 500. Can we get above it? I don't think that happens, but it just seems to be a hurdle for some reason. And if they can get some momentum going into that road trip, put some more points between themselves and Bozeman, and then get a couple of wins or even one win is probably what you can hope for on the road against Billings, just to put the doubt in Billings' mind that they can't come in and just take us for granted. This game tonight could be a pole vault to next weekend, and I think next weekend is an absolutely huge weekend.
Well, you said it, and people have to remember, we have 6 regular season home games left, including tonight. That's 6. 9 on the road. This is going to make a difference. Bismarck has a game in hand on us. I believe they have 3, so we could burn up one right here. And it's all important to get that extra 2 points on these guys. Move within one. Hey, Kimberly could beat them tomorrow night. If Kimberly moves up by 8, we're still in the hunt. The idea, remain focused, really show the league and show every team in the league that this month, start flying out there, be dominant on whole ice, but also when you get on the road, let's go get those wins off the Billings. Let's go get those wins off of Bozeman. Put the shaking throughout the league and let them know that, hey, the Riders are here to defend without question. Even though we got a whole new roster up on that Ghost Rider team, it's going to make a difference.
Who do you root for in a Bismarck-Kimberly game? That's kind of tough. I'd almost root for Kimberly, you know, for Bismarck rather, because I don't want to see Kimberly pull any further ahead of us for that fourth spot, because that's home ice advantage. Leapfrogging Bismarck, if they get 2 or 3 points ahead of us, is doable. But Kimberly going 8 points up on us at this time of the year that gap might start to become insurmountable.
You said it. If we can beat Bismarck tonight, we pull within 1. So we also pull within 4 or 5 of Kimberly.
4.
Yeah. So that's even better yet.
Then if Bismarck goes in and beats Kimberly with 3 back of Bismarck and 4 of Kimberly,
yeah,
that's doable.
You said it.
It's still 2 teams to catch, though.
Yes, 2 teams to catch, but we're not out of reach. You gotta look who Bismarck's got to play. They got to play Great Falls. They got to play Billings. They got to play Minot. Those teams that they've been losing to.
Do you know where Great Falls is tonight?
Yeah, Fairbanks.
Is that going to be a slaughter?
You know what I would like to see? I like to see the Ice Dogs beat them.
You know what?
Yeah,
I looked at the internet and I went, oh, this is going to be ugly. And I thought, wait a minute. Wouldn't this be nice if this was their one win? Would that ever give those guys confidence?
Oh, yeah.
I said at the beginning of the year, though, they shouldn't be able to beat one of us.
No. It's an eye-opening experience. Steve Nelson, the commissioner of the AWHL, he's up there. He's going to make an announcement in front of their fans. And I heard that they're going to pack in about 2,500 in the Big Dipper up there. So who better to make the announcement when you have the number one leading team in the league up there playing your Ice Dogs? And they could take them lightly. And if you take them lightly, like any competitor, you could end up being on the short side.
Great Falls can just turn it on so easy, though.
Yeah.
Might be a bit of a mismatch there, but...
It might, but the thing is, Great Falls relies on 3 players. Kiskis and Dwyer on one line, for example. You look at their stats. Dwyer's got 80 points. Kiskis got 69 points. You go down to the third guy, and that's Mo. He's got like 48. Not even 48. He's got like 40 points. Like, you're talking a 20-point differential right there between their second guy to the third guy. You're not going to win a championship. I say that all the time.
They got
defense and goaltending, but if you keep on coming and teams keep on pounding your demon in the corners like we aggressively did in our arena and we beat them, hey, that says a lot. And the thing is, we're not going to be the only team. Billings has done it. Minot will do it because, like, Bozeman is always saying, well, how do we control this team? You hit them. hit their top guns, and that makes a difference. If you don't have more than one guy scoring on your team, you're going to have problems. And if you look at the stats, like from top to bottom, we got three more guys available in the top 20, and it could happen.
Just finish off with this. I don't want to talk about Great Falls or Fairbanks anymore, but Fairbanks plays a similar, they're not the same as us, but similar to us. A bit of a smaller team, they do have some speed. Yeah. That's why there were close games between us down there. We eventually pulled away at the end, but here's hoping they do something against Great Falls. We'll be back in about 2 minutes and 45 seconds in real time, but just a blink on Kootenai Cable for first period action. Welcome to Ghost Riders Hockey on Kootenai Cable, the Bobcats and the Riders. As you heard in the pregame show, the Riders yet to beat the Bobcats this year. 4-0 are the Bobcats against your Fernie Ghost Riders, but off the start, Riders out of their own zone. Pass through center, picked up by Ryan Wiggins, the slap back in, just wide of Joey Jamal Ali. And Ali makes the first stop of the game, and he'll hang on. Joey Jamal Ali, the runner-up for the Player of the Week honors in the America West Hockey League last week. He had a 2.00 goals against average and a save percentage well above 900 in those three games. It was one against Bozeman in that pair of games against Minot on Saturday and Sunday. So Joey Jamal Ali, runner-up for the Player of the Week in the AWHL. Had a good weekend, and he's back, folks. He's looking like he did when when the Riders went on that 10-game streak where they only lost the one game. Actually, at one point, they had a tie in that 10-game streak, so really undefeated in 10 games. Now the Riders send the puck back into Bismarck's zone. Kelly Ryan Arch behind the net, sent over to Wiggins. Wiggins, backhand pass in the corner to Jason Asadourian. Back to the point, Murphy keeps it in. Puck deflected, shot up high in the air, and landed behind the net. Chris Unice in net tonight for the Bismarck Bobcats. Riders at center, Jim Murphy. Skates the puck through center, lifts a high one in. And Unice will just hang on to it with a pair of Ghost Riders, Jeremy Robinson and Connor Hughes on the doorstep. Face off now to the glove hand left of Chris Unice. Riders win the faceoff. Bishaya takes the puck to his backhand, bounces it off the boards, but it's picked up there and dumped out by Tom Erickson. Through center, chipped in by Andy Allen, captain of the Bobcats, now behind the net. Riders set it up. Robbie Godfrey comes out from behind his own net. Pass up the right side. Bishaya couldn't handle it. Tried to backhand to Coma, but it went too far for him. And Mike Waterleck, back in his own zone, gives the puck away to Bishaya, though. Bishaya in the slot area, gets it to Saylor. Saylor moves to the faceoff, circle his shot, and you need to stop that. Now Saylor, puck back to his wing, slaps at it, can't get it down the boards, past Tom Erickson. Erickson battling with Saylor now. Puck comes loose, Bobcats have it, and they'll get it out to center. Jim Murphy sends the puck back to the line, but knocked down. Now brought back through the middle by Mike Waterleck. Gets around Murphy, but pushed in behind the net now as Murphy recovers. Nice job there by the veteran D-man for the Riders. Jared Saylor follows the puck up the sideboards, but it's kept in by the Bobcats. But Saylor's positioning is good because he gets the puck right back. Now Murphy takes the pass on the far side boards. Puck sent back through center. Jakub Koma bounces it off the sideboards in deep. Kyle Shane gives chase along with Brent Popovich. Puck off the sideboards. Bobcats send it out to center. Kyle Shane backhands it to the blue line where Ryan Vesely picked it up and brought it back to center ice. Puck is just shot in deep. Ali controls the rebound off the backboards for Cullen. Cullen can't get it to Shane. It was too far for him. The puck's out to center. Shot back in by the Bobcats, Dan Powell. And Jake Posnikov behind his own net. Posnikov back on defense tonight. A familiar position for him, but not so familiar lately as he's been playing a lot of forward. Now Ryan Cullen taps the puck up to Popovich, gets it out to center, but the Bobcats send it back in. That'll be offside. Off at center, John Rudnick wins the draw. Bobcats start up ice. Kelly Reinhartz dumps it in. Backpedaling in his own zone. Cullen now picks it up. In behind the net. Cullen sends a pass up through center off the skate of Kyle Shane. Picked up there and sent back in by Scott Honkola. Jake Posnikov sets up behind his own net. Decides to bring it out himself. Posnikov pass to the far boards to Downey. Gets up to Kyle Shane off the glass and in deep. Popovich gives chase. Popovich pulled down to the ice, no call. Puck back to the point where Cullen kept it in. Now Popovich along the far boards, rubs his man out of the play. That was Eric Paulsen taken out. Now in to help out is John Rudnick. Bobcats bring it up through center. Backhand in, past Cullen. Cullen will have to pick the puck up behind his own net now. Looking up ice, decides to go with it himself. Now passes off to McLeod, the speedy forward. Stopped just as he gets over the center ice line, though. Now McLeod back to it, far board. Slaps it in. Just gets it past Erickson, but Erickson plays it off quickly to Dave Scott. Stout picks it up at center, sends it back to the Bismarck blue line. McLeod gets in his way. Now Kissick comes in to throw a check, but he misses. Bobcats get it in. Shot wide of Joey Jamal Ali. Now a shot. Deflected on net, just a tap on net by Ryan Wiggins. He's got 7 points in four games this year against the Riders. Now the puck, far boards, Brent Halverson. Picked up just before we arrived in Bismarck, you'll remember, on that last road trip. Brought in from the USHL, played for Bozeman last year. A shot on net, Ali kicks that out. Now Wagman takes the puck behind his own net, looks up ice, chips the puck out over the blue line. Chris Kissick peels off for the change instead of going after it. That brings a line of Hughes, Robinson, and Palmer out. Bobcats looking good here for the beginning of a road period for a team who's supposed to have bus legs. Now the puck back in their own zone. Ryan Vesely dumped it past Robinson. Palmer comes into the corner to help out. Ends up with the puck, tried to get it to Hughes, but it's picked off there by Wiggins. Now up through center, Bobcats bring it in. Shot just wide of the net. Now Connor Hughes has Jeremy Robinson with him. It's a two-on-one. Hughes goes to the backhand. Can't get the pass out front. Now gets it back nearly to the point as Godfrey couldn't hang on to it. Now a pass cross ice picked up there by Andy Allen. Puts a shot on net. Ali makes the stop and he'll hang on. The Bobcats, good speed here to start this game. Jeremy Robinson takes the puck in behind the net. Robinson now comes out right in front of his own net. Gets a cross ice pass for Hughes. Hughes has to put on the brakes to catch up to it, though. Now a penalty coming up. It's going to go against Bismarck, so the Riders are going to get a power play opportunity here. First power play opportunity of the night. It comes at the 5:30 mark. Now Pashea brings the puck up ice. Pashea in over the line. He's got Kyle Shane breaking towards the front of the net. Backhander went off a skate and nearly went in. Yanis had to be quick on that one. Yanis, very short goaltender. See if the Riders can take advantage of that. Now Halverson tries to outrace Stout. Back in to pick it up. That was Coma. Now Coma lost the puck in front of the net, and it was just sort of kicked on net. Wouldn't have counted. Keith Townsend, the Bismarck captain, is not an underage player, but he still wears that full face mask. Flyers still on the power play for another minute and a half. Off the faceoff, Alex Stout takes the puck behind his own net. Gets a pass up to Connor Hughes. Hughes scoots up the far boards. Puck is swept off his stick, and Godfrey has it. Chased back into his own zone by Adam Kostichka. Now Hughes, bring it out of his own zone, stripped of the puck by Kostichka. A minute and two left in this power play now. Now Godfrey, knocked off the puck. Godfrey's down on the ice. Riders get it anyway. Connor Hughes brings the puck in deep. Has it on his backhand, puts it back in the corner. There's 34 seconds left. Godfrey is very slow to get to the bench, but now Pashaya came on for him. So Riders back to a man advantage. Now Palmer off his backhand, put the puck back in the corner to Robinson. Robinson puts it back to the point of Pashaya. Shot. Eunice made the stop. Now the puck cleared down the ice. 16 seconds left. Ali plays it to Stout. Stout takes it behind his own net. The broadcasts were changing. Could have been an opportunity to get a quick pass up ice, but Stout now dumps up to Hughes, who wants to change. Riders nearly get caught there as the puck bounced off the backboards, and Paulson got a shot. Now Colma tried to strip his man of the puck. Bobcats have it. Halvorsen at center. Just off the boards and in. Stout chases it back into his own zone. 12:21 left in the first period. No score to report here. Bobcats and Ghost Riders. And now Ali will just hang on as Halvorsen cruises through the slot area. And the Ghost Riders look very flat here to start the game. Bobcats getting a number of good chances. None of them have been solid scoring chances, but chances at good scoring chances, I guess you could say. The draw. Cullen chases the puck back at the faceoff circle, gets up to Kyle Shane. He's hitting to the boards hard, but Shane's a bigger guy, so he'll be okay. Popanich stood up as he tried to come in. Bobcats get it up the sideboards. Popanich keeps it in, gets a shot towards the net through traffic, but Eunice got a pad on it. Initial shootout attempt was fanned on, but the Bobcats got it out anyway. Ali settles it down behind the net for Posnikov. Posnikov will skate it up ice, gets a pass up to Downey. Downey with Popanich and Shane in over the line. Downey in the corner, carries in behind the net. Tag team there and knocked to the ice. Kyle Shane loses the puck off his stick, and now Wiggins just bangs it down the ice. Face-off, Bobcats set up behind their own net. Dan Powell got the puck back to the point, kept in by the Riders. Now McLeod at center, able to sweep it back in. Bobcats out to the middle again. Murphy knocks it back in. Standing there waiting for a penalty was Andy Allen, but no call. Now the puck brought up ice. Backhand shot on net is held onto by Ali. It's Mike Waterleck got down ice. Murphy off the faceoff, pushes the puck behind the net. Andy Allen now carries against Godfrey, who's back out after taking that either a shoulder pad or a stick in the face. I'm not sure what it was with that hit in the defensive zone earlier in the period. Murphy off the boards and out, gets it to McLeod. McLeod back to Wasmith to Kisick. Kisick on the backhand, can't get it through Eunice, and now Eunice down. Robinson off the faceoff for Hughes. Pass into the corner for Robinson. Robinson spins away from his check, still with the puck. Palmer comes in to help out. He's pushed up against the boards. Now Palmer breaks free. So does the puck. So Palmer goes to it first, out of the corner. Back to the point to Wagman. Tees up and shoots. Rebound in the slot area. Robinson couldn't corral the rebound. of the Bobcats, trying to get it out, but they can't. Now on second effort, they might be able to. Puck back in the corner. Now Robinson out front. One-timer Hughes, stopped by Eunice. That was just a matter of the goaltender being in the right spot at the right time. Eunice, that puck hit him more than he stopped it. And now the puck's up on the top of the net as Ali had it shoot up over his shoulder pad. And with 10 minutes flat, the Riders have had their best couple of scoring chances in about the last minute and a half here. Off the faceoff, Jan Pashea pushes the puck up to the blue line. Coma chased it down at center but couldn't pick it up. Bobcats pushed it into the Fernie zone, but Wagman gets it right back out. Now Jakob Coma with some speed. Sater catching up. Coma shoots, and it's off the face mask, I think, of Eunice. Sater was catching up on the two-on-one, but Coma elected to shoot the puck. Now Sater goes into the corner with his man. Pashea in to pull the puck free. Gets his stick free. Now pulled down. Puck was bouncing in the slot area. Bobcats pick it up and send it down ice. Pashea upset there was no penalty called there, and I don't blame him. Now Stout hammered into the backboards. Puck goes all the way down the ice, though. Icing waved off. Bobcats bring the puck up ice through center. Postikov stops that attempt into the zone, takes his man, and before they can forecheck, now the Bobcats in front of the net couldn't pull the trigger. Riders get it out of the zone. Center ice slapped in. Ali kicks that into the corner. Postnikov fell, but there's Downey to back him up. Downey brings the puck up ice, gets it to Popovich. Popovich has the puck swept off a stick at the last minute, or Kyle Shane might have been breaking free down the other side. Now Cullen stepped in front of Halvorsen, and that broke up the play coming out of the Bismarck zone. Riders are offside, the delayed offside. Now Shane picks it off, gets it back to Cullen. Cullen off the boards, get it to Kyle Shane, but he's held up, can't get into the zone. Now Popovich overskated the puck, just backhand into the corner. Downey takes Wiggins into the boards. The puck fired down the ice, and Ali lets it go. That'll be icing. Face-off, puck through center, Godfrey takes it away from Allen, who was streaking up ice, but now the puck sent into Bismarck territory. Godfrey backs off as it comes back out to center. Murphy takes the pass from Godfrey, looks up ice, chips it off the boards, looking for McLeod. Puck helped in the rest of the way. Now Kissick chases his man behind the net. Bobcats get it out. Godfrey gives chase back into his own zone. Robbie Godfrey, 3 goals last weekend in those 3 games, all on the power play. Now the puck behind the net. Eunice just taps it into the corner. Wasmuth being held up as he tried to go to the sideboards. Now McLeod in to help out. Bobcats bring it up through center, and it went off Andy Allen. That's going to be down the ice all the way for Murphy to touch up. That'll be another icing call. Alex Stout off the draw, carries the puck down the near boards into the left corner now, dumped it in behind the net. Halvorsen picks it up. Robinson angle him into the corner, so Halvorsen just dumps it back down the ice, and Palmer will touch up for the icing again. Bobcats are getting a penalty. I'm not sure for what. Well, Sean Petkow on the camera here telling me it's a too many men penalty. I'm not sure. I'll tell you the truth, I didn't see the infraction.
Hey,
was for something that Eriksson said to the linesman down there. He went back and really gave it to the linesman. Linesman, after the play, came over and singled him out. So it won't be a power play. It wasn't too many men on the ice. I thought that I saw him giving it to Petras or Levine. I can't remember which one it was now, but obviously he said something he really shouldn't have. Linesman told the ref, and now he's in the box. Stout with a backhand shot, and the rebound cleared up into the stands. And Stout knocked down twice, and now the Bobcats are going to get a penalty. I think it's going to be two roughing penalties to the Bobcats, one on the goaltender and one on Brent Halvorsen. And Alex Stout really should not have gone back after Halvorsen, because I think the Bobcats were going to get a pair of penalties out of that. Stout may have cost his team one of the minor penalties. I think the Bobcats were going to get two roughing penalties out of that. Bobcats were only going to get the one penalty out of that, but still goes back to Stout. Shouldn't have come back after Halvorsen. Take the penalty and sit down. Get him later if you want to get him.
Penalties on the play of Bismarck, Bobcats number 21. Brandon.
There's always something to be said for standing up for yourself, though, too. And in that regard, Stout maybe thought that's what he had to do. So I have to give him the benefit of the doubt on that one, because quite possibly Stout just said, I'm not going to take that. Now Palmer takes the puck into the corner. Gets back to the point for Godfrey. Godfrey winds up and shoots, and the puck held onto by Eunice. That'll be a faceoff to the glove hand left of Eunice, deep in Bismarck territory. The draw, Robinson wins it, but it goes between the two riders, defenseman Murphy and Godfrey. Now Wiggins takes it off the near boards, a shot blocked by Murphy. Murphy out there with Hughes, back to Murphy, up to Godfrey. Godfrey skates it up ice, gets in over the blue line, pass back to Palmer. Palmer tap back to Murphy, a shot. That was tipped wide by the goaltender. Now Robinson sends it back to the point to Godfrey. Off the sideboards to Robinson. Out front, they tip it, scores! Mark Palmer on the power play. Mark Palmer is 16th on the year. Of course, the stats say he has 17, but one of those goals belongs to Connor Hughes. Nonetheless, Mark Palmer has the Ghost Riders on the board.
Scored by number 17, Mark Palmer, with assist to number 22, Jeremy Robinson, and to number 9, Rob Gutter.
Actually, that is not his 16th, that is his 17th. As Coma breaks in now, just loses the puck. So number 17 on the year for number 17, the Fernie captain, gets his team on the board first. Wiggins runs over Murphy. Murphy likely won't forget that. Bobcats through center, trailing 1-0, 5:20 left in the first. Murphy did a good job there of keeping his man from getting around him. That was Jason Asadourian. And now a penalty. So Murphy hit his man, and that looks like it's going to be possibly a checking from behind or roughing. don't see out there is Aleix Perez. I haven't seen Perez all night. Wonder if Perez is injured, and maybe I'll get the skinny on that for you in the first intermission here. I apologize for not being able to call that penalty properly. I wasn't really looking at the play. I was looking down at my stat sheet, as I said, but it's a holding penalty. Now the Bobcats keep it in the zone, but Coma fires it down. On net, Yunis stops that. Bobcats look to bring it out. Connor Hughes bumps his man, knocked him off the puck momentarily. Now Wiggins has it, bumps into his old man. Now Postnikov pushes his man into the corner. Postnikov taking Keith Townsend out of the play. Now Wiggins back to the point for Andy Allen. A shot goes wide. Off the sideboards, Ali makes another stop. Cullen now gets it out over the blue line. Palmer and Hughes out there on the penalty kill. Allen backhand pass through center, picked up by Honkola. Now the Riders again with it as Connor Hughes knocked off stride there by Waterleck. Hughes gets to the puck though as the Bobcats tried to bring out of the zone. Picked up by Kelly Reinhartz now and sent back out. Riders at center though, turn the Bobcats back into their own zone. 41 seconds left. Riders so far tonight, 1-for-2. Bobcats' first opportunity on the power play. Now Wasmuth picks it up, backhands it on net, and that's Eunice who just gloves it and hangs on. And Wasmuth does a good job of getting in right on top of the goaltender and causing him not to be able to play the puck, and that'll bring to keep the faceoff in Bismarck territory. Seconds now left on Bismarck's power play. Connor Hughes off the draw. Puck goes into the corner. Bobcats just send a high one out to center. Stopped by Wagman and now knocked down by Hughes. A glove hand pass. Just 22 seconds left in the Bismarck power play. The draw, Bobcats control again. Kelly Reinhartz skates up from his own line, dumps it in deep into Fernie territory. Ali out to settle it down, but it goes past him and around the other side. Halverson send it behind the net, too far for Wiggins. Matt Erickson dumps it back into the corner. Waterleck spins away from his man. Wiggins circles into the faceoff area. Now Hughes gets it to Murphy. Murphy with the breakaway, but doesn't have any speed going and can't get a good shot away, but he got it towards the net anyway. Murphy throws a hit on Wiggins and the Riders come up with the puck. Tyler Wagman sidesteps a check and Kelly Reinhartz throws himself into the boards. Robinson spins away from his man, but a checking from behind penalty coming up as the Bobcats touch it, and that's a brutal play. He's going to be gone, and so be it. Matt Erickson going to the penalty box. Jeremy Robinson, okay, but that's a pretty clear check from behind.
Bismarck Bobcats number 5.
Rangers on the power play. Bobcats right off the draw, though, just rifle the puck up and out of play. So the faceoff will stay in their zone. Fernie so far 1-for-2 on the power play. Mark Palmer getting his 17th on the year from Rob Godfrey and Jeremy Robinson. Robinson now, for your information, has now extended his point streak to 14 points in 8 games. So Jeremy Robinson been playing very, very well of late. Vesely behind the net, chased down by Saylor. Bobcats try and get it out, but the Riders converge on it. Now Coma, back to the point for Stout, but it's too far. Stout being chased down, so decides to go cross ice with it to Pashaya. Pashaya being watched by John Rudnick, goes back behind the net for Stout. Rudnick peels off. Stout leaves it for Coma. Coma will skate it up ice now. Backhand pass. They get it into the zone. Coma now follows up as Saylor went for the puck. Shane now in the corner. Riders should come out with the puck as they've got numbers. Get it to Kyle Shane. Saylor behind the net now. Looking to set something up. Saylor back in the corner for Coma. Back to the point for Stout. Stout cross ice for Pashaya. Pashaya just lifts it back behind the net. Saylor goes to it. Minute 2 left. Saylor behind the net for Coma. Coleman Vesely battle behind the net. Now Saylor pulls it free. Saylor to the faceoff circle. Now a shot from a bad angle. Eunice made that stop. Saylor puts a puck into the corner. Kyle Shane spins away from his man. Gets it out. Tried to get it front for Saylor. Saylor swept, took a swipe at it, but the puck was too high. The puck's all the way down the ice. Alex Stout has it in his own zone. Stout rubbed out by Waterleck. Waterleck comes up with the puck now, and Hughes gets in the way of that. Robinson gets in the way of a second attempt by Waterleck, but Waterleck gets it back again. Now the Bobcats pick it up, get a shot on net, but Ali just sticks that to the corner. Now Stout picks the puck up in his own zone. In on the forecheck is Andy Allen. Stout plays it near boards, left side for Jeremy Robinson. Robinson all the way up ice. Cross ice for Hughes on the backhand. And Eunice didn't see that or didn't. Not a very good effort anyway trying to stop it. Now Stout with a shot. Just goes wide. Team's back at full strength now. Puck sent all the way down the ice and Godfrey's in a foot race. So Ali will just play it around away from the forechecking Bobcat. Stout dumps it off the sideboards to Palmer. Palmer gets across ice for Godfrey. Immediately one pass, one times up to Robinson. Robinson goes into the corner. His man falls down in front of him, so Robinson able to dig the puck free. But the Bobcat's there to cover. As the puck goes all the way down the ice, it'll be an icing call. Ryan Cullen's back to pick it up. On the faceoff, gets it to Shane. Shane atop the faceoff circle, shot just wide of the net. Now the puck knocked down by what looked like a high stick, but the referee immediately waves it off. 22 seconds left. Puck dumped behind the net for Popadich, but he had to chase his man down, so the puck is just sent back to the point now. Shot on net, deflected, just went wide. Shane hauled down, but no call. Now the puck sent out with 8 seconds left, out to center. Downey has it and just flips it right back in. The Bobcats will just look to kill off the rest of this time, I think, and be lucky to get out of this period only down one. So the score after one period of play, the Fernie Ghost Riders 1, Bismarck Bobcats no score. Riders getting the only goal of the game on the power play so far. That's Mark Palmer's 17th of the season from Jeremy Robinson and Robbie Godfrey. That play coming on the power play. So we'll be back in a blink with more Ghost Riders action in second period right after this. Set to start the second period now. Riders up 1-0, having just killed off a second power play opportunity by the Bobcats. So right now, Bismarck 0-for-2 to start the second period. Fernie 1-for-3. Shots after 1, 13-11 in favor of the Ghost Riders. Play starts in Fernie territory. Wiggins pushes the puck behind the net. Halverson tries to get it out front. Ali's down on top of it. And the referee blows the whistle. Not in the lineup tonight. Adrian Chubani not in the lineup tonight. And Derek Aquila still nursing that ankle injury. Off the faceoff. Puck squirts under Connor Hughes. Now a shot on net. And Ali makes the stop. The rebound goes through Ali and out the other side. Now the puck sent out to center. Back to pick it up is Jason Asadourian. Cross ice pass, trying to flip it. That was Honkola, but it went off Halverson. Now the Riders end up with the puck just for a moment, though, as Robinson lost it to Jason Asadourian. Now Stout rubs Wiggins out of the play. Halverson goes into the corner after Robinson. Holds up as Robinson's already taken one check from behind tonight. Nice job there by Halverson. I'll give him all the credit in the world for holding up there as Robinson's back was turned. Now Halverson comes in on Ali, looking to go to the backhand, but puck taken away from him by Palmer. Now Halverson's going to go to the box for 10 minutes, at least 10 minutes. Actually took himself out of the play to skate over to the referee and say something. So not only was he out of the play for a good long time, a 5-on-4 up ice. Halverson was well out of position, but he takes a misconduct as well. So after giving him credit for holding up on Robinson when he went to the corner, now Halverson takes a 10-minute misconduct right after that for something not so bright. Now Pashea out front for Colma, but that's cut off. Riders have it in Bismarck territory. Puck shot up straight in the air as a collision between sticks caused the puck to shoot up. Now the Bobcats bring it out. Puck off a skate and down the ice. Ali stays in his own net as Murphy's back to pick it up. Murphy takes a bump on the play, but the puck is sent all the way around the boards and down the ice. Bobcats touch up. That'll be an icing call. Off in for any territory. Just under 2 minutes gone in this second period. Riders still lead 1-0. Cullen off the backboards to Downey. He just flips it up and out. Popadich chases the puck. But the Bobcats able to send it back to center. Delayed offside now. Bobcats bring it out. Wiggins played it back into the middle. Bobcats in over the line. Ali makes a stop as the puck came in through a screen. The Riders get it out to center. Kyle Shane bumped off the puck. Puck sent in deep. Downey chases his man to the backboards. Wiggins takes the puck off the near side. Starts to head up ice. Steps around a man. Now they get in over the line. Go, go, go. Nice job by Kyle Shane to be back, though. Popadich now brings it through center. Postnikov catching up on the play. He was the third man coming through. Off now in Bismarck territory, just over 2.5 minutes gone in this second period, 1-0 Riders up on the Bismarck Bobcats. Lone goal of the game by Captain Mark Palmer on the power play as Ryan McLeod continues to dish out the big hits this year, and now the puck is sent down the ice and the play will come back up ice. Ghost Riders on that shift. Four guys out there under the age of 18. Wagman, Stout, McLeod, and Wasmuth. I think Wasmuth's the only guy to that group who's even 17. And they all stay out there. That's about as young a line as you're going to get out there for the Ghost Riders. Looks like a bantam hockey game with all those face masks out there. Ryan McLeod steals the puck at the blue line, sends it in behind the net. Bobcats a little confused in their own zone as the Riders doing a good job forechecking. They've really come on since I mentioned they were being outplayed. Maybe I should talk like that the whole game. Now McLeod bumped off the puck. Bobcats able to get into the zone, keeping it at the blue line now. Pass across, nearly knocked down by Paulson for a one-timer. Wagman knocks his man down. Now McLeod goes into the corner. Paulson heads back along the near boards. Now stick handles into the faceoff circle, spins away from his man, a shot in front. Rebound is lying loose. Good job there by Tyler Wagman. Solid defensive play as he blocked that shot. Now Ali falls. Puck comes back out front, and Palmer decides just to lob it out through center. Icing waved off. Kelly Reinhartz behind his own net starts to play back out through center. Bobcats look to set up. A long shot in on Ali. It went off the post. And Ali nearly handcuffed by that long shot. Now Robinson up to Hughes, who gets in over the line. Hughes with a shot. Stop made, and the rebound knocked down by Vesely. His goaltender had it, but then Vesely knocked it down. Now Godfrey skates back for it, and he'll touch up.
A $450 diamond ring, and the 50-50 is in the audience wearing a Ghost Rider jersey. The 50-50 tickets are double prize tonight. First prize drawn is sponsored by James Jewelers, a $1,000 diamond bracelet, and the second prize will be for the cash. So we got double prizes on 50-50 tonight. Grab your 50-50.
Off the faceoff, Riders dump the puck in deep. Robinson spins away from Waterleck. Bobcats send the puck up near the blue line, but Robinson steps into it at the top of the faceoff circle. Now they should be able to get out as Vesely backhands it down the ice. Murphy gets the puck out to center. Waterleck looked like he was going to be able to get it back in, but now Palmer brings it up. Palmer shoots it in. Hughes chases his man into the corner. Hughes hammers his man against the boards. Nice hit by Connor Hughes. Now the play outside the Bismarck line. Murphy has to put it back in even though Hughes is trapped deep. Bobcats clear, so it didn't matter anyway. Now a shot goes off the base of the net. That's two long shots that have nearly beaten Ali. And if you remember, I think it was a couple of long shots in the Bismarck game in the first place that beat Joey and Bill Dick. Two goalies in net that night. Now Palmer a shot on net, but Yanis keeps that out. And the puck fired up out of play into the stands. And Bo Jack looked up and smiled at the crowd. That's a ridiculous thing to do. That's not even, I won't even dignify calling that kid a hockey player. You shoot the puck into the stands and smile at the guy it hits. That's unbelievably poor taste. I'm having trouble even finding words to describe that without getting kicked off the air here. Kid's not a hockey player. That's all I have to say. Puck sent down the ice. Posnikov behind the net. Rifles it around the boards. Pashea. Tapped it down the ice, now behind the net. Picked up by Kelly Reinhartz, but the Ghost Rider's in on the forecheck. Now some holding up at the side of the net as Saylor was being held. Posnikov keeps the Bobcats from getting into the zone. Now a wide shoot in by Reinhartz. Puck bounces to Posnikov behind the net. He's bumped into by Wiggins, but Posnikov doesn't give up any size to Wiggins, and Wiggins just bounced off him. Minutes flat left in this second period. Brett Downey on the faceoff to the glove hand left of Joey Ali in the rider zone. Bobcats off the faceoff, got a shot towards the net, but it was off a skate. Now Popovich dumps the puck off the sideboards. Downey picks it up, gets it to Stout. Collision at center, but Stout and John Rudnick both remain standing. Now Downey stuck his knee out. That's going to be a penalty. And Ali will just come out of his net and hang on to it. Wasn't disguised very well by Downey. That was very blatant at center ice. No harm done. I don't think Brett meant to hurt anybody there. Downey's not that type of player, but did stick the leg out nonetheless. Off the draw. Connor Hughes tries to play the puck back into the corner, but Palmer ends up with it, and he smacks it out to center. Puck just labors just inside the Bismarck line. Andy Allen brings the puck behind the net. Bobcats look to set it up in their own zone. Bobcats co-captain brings it out of his own zone. Palmer got a piece of that, and Godfrey got a piece of it as well as it went into Fernie territory. Godfrey pulled down. Now from his knees, pass goes back to the point from Townsend. Cross-ice pass now broken up. Connor Hughes and Jim Murphy bring the puck up ice. Hughes takes a return pass, goes wide, tries to get in on the goaltender, goes around behind the net, plays the puck back to the point. Palmer played it back to Godfrey. Now Godfrey just turns around and hammers it back up ice. That killed off probably a good 20 seconds. Now the Riders are going to be able to kill off some more, as Connor Hughes was nearly in the right position there just to take that one-time tip from the goaltender and put it back in his net. Now Ali makes the stop as the Bobcats are starting to shoot long on Ali as they noticed him trouble handling a couple of shots. And like I said, when we were in Bismarck, I believe that was the strategy there as well, was to shoot long. And a couple of those shots went in. 45 seconds left in the second period, or rather in the power play. 12 minutes and change left in the second period. Now a pass in front of the net. Went wide and it bounced onto the back of the mesh. So faceoff will be inside Fernie territory, I think.
002461 to register at the booster table in the lobby to participate in the Alpine Resort puck shoot, which will take place between the second.
33 seconds left on the power play now for the Bobcats. 0 for 2 on the night so far. Stout picks the puck up and rings it out along the far boards. Unice out of his own net. Bobcats will skate it out of their own zone through center. Pass gets him into the zone, but Wiggins fanned on it. Now Coma has got a partial breakaway. Coma in alone on the goal. He scores! Jakob Coma! Short-handed goal by Jakob Coma. Jakob Coma is going to be relieved of that goal. You saw how happy he was. He hasn't scored in quite some time. That's his 25th on the year. With 9 seconds still left on the power play. Do a world of good for Jakob's confidence.
Second goal, a shorthanded goal scored by number 16, Jakob Coma, with assist to number 8, Tyler Wagman. Time of the goal, 9-11.
So Tyler Wagman gets the assist on Coma's 25th of the year, shorthanded. Team's now even. Pass to center, Downey plays it to Coma on a two-line pass. Petras waves it down. Jan Pache is going to say he was over the blue line. The faceoff now. Riders get the puck over the blue line. Kissick tap back to McLeod, but the Bobcats pick it up at their own line. Kissick chases his man down at center, just sort of slipped into Fernie territory. Murphy behind his net gets away from one man. Now the forecheck comes, so he banks it off the sideboards out to center, picked off there by Bo Jack, the Jack you know what, who shot a puck in the crowd and smiled at everybody. Ali makes one save on that shot from a sharp angle on Paulson. Riders in their own zone. Murphy behind the net. Sent the puck up to Wasman that jumped over his stick. Now the Bobcats with a chance in the slot area. But now the Riders turn it right back as Kissick has the puck swept off his stick. McLeod fires it in. Takes a bit of a hit there from Kostichka, but don't think McLeod felt that one. Allen with the puck just outside the Riders' line. Backhanded in. Murphy will be the first man there behind the net. Lots of room on that far side. Just decides to skate it up the boards out of his own zone. Tried to chip it along the boards, but couldn't. Now a two-on-one shaping up here. If Cullen can't get back across, now a breakaway. And Waterleck shot the puck high and wide as Ali came out to cut the angle down slightly. Didn't give Waterleck much to shoot at there. Now Robinson sends it around the far boards to Palmer. Palmer gets it up to Hughes. Now Hughes in a one-on-one. Tries to get around his man. Can't cut in as the goaltender came out to break up that play as well. Now Palmer gets back as Waterlek skates in down the far side. Back pass picked off by Robinson.
Go, go, go!
Now Connor Hughes has it. Hughes has Palmer breaking through the middle. Palmer has Postnikov catching up. Now Palmer from outside the line, shot, and Yanis makes the stop, and he'll just hang on. Hughes and Robinson out on this faceoff. Robinson wins it cleanly. Back to Stout. Stout waits for something to set up in front. Now a shot. Rebound went past Palmer. Now Stout takes it. Bobcat side of the red line and just dumps it back in. Palmer gives chase behind the net. Played away by Yanis, though. Hughes, first man there, plays it back in behind the net. Kelly Reinhart's there. Tries the other side, gets it out past Hughes. Wiggins flips it up through center, and Wagman gets in the way of his man. Now Stout carries the puck, tried to carry the puck in behind the net, but he was taken out by Townsend. Now the puck up the boards. Bobcats retreat back to their own blue line. Scott Honkola played it through center. Icing waved off as it went off a skate. Now Stout brings it around the boards, kept in by the Bobcats, but Wagman knocks it down, takes a bit of a bump. Robinson comes in to help out. Now Wagman with a second chance to get it up, but Wiggins takes it off. Now Townsend shot, and Ali makes the stop. Townsend
holding your future, a $1,000 diamond bracelet from James Jewelers downtown Fernie, as well as the regular cash prize being drawn on a second ticket. So grab your 50-50 tickets tonight. You get double prizes. Support the Fernie Ghostbusters.
Riders off the faceoff, get the puck to the blue line. Bobcats keep it in, though. Puck goes wide of the net, now squirts to the far boards. Shot, Ali kicks that out. Bobcats carrying behind the net, and what a hit! Nice hit by Jakub Koma.
No! Stay with them! Stay with them!
Bobcats try and keep it in the blue line. Now Murphy has his stick lifted at the last second. Godfrey carries back behind his own net as he's being bothered there by Erik Paulsson. Now the forecheck comes in from the other side, so the Riders try the near board, but they can't get out. Godfrey plays up to Saylor, far side. Saylor chips it off to Koma. Now Koma tries to get around his man. Pashaya just put the puck wide. And now there's going to be an interference call or holding as the Bobcats can't deal with Jakub Koma's speed. Face off to start the power play. Bobcats have the puck dumped down the ice.
2 minutes for holding. Time of the penalty, 11-4.
Now Joey Ali leaves the puck for Alex Stout. Stout heads out the other side. Robinson chips it past Townsend. Now Hughes tried to step in front of that, but it was picked off by Kelly Reinhart. Now a high stick made contact, so the faceoff will be in Fernie territory. Face-off, Bobcats dump it into the corner. Robinson is grabbed onto and nearly pulled down, but no call. Now Stout spins away from Townsend, but Townsend pushes him into the boards. Now Townsend put the puck out front. There was a man alone in front, but the puck didn't get to him. Townsend still in the offensive zone, has to get out. Bobcats delayed offside. Now Robinson plays it, tried to get it to Hughes, but I think it hit the linesman. Now Stout plays it to Robinson. Cross ice to Godfrey. He carries it in. Back pass to Palmer. Palmer carries it down the far boards into the corner. Now behind the net to Hughes. Hughes to Robinson near side. Back to the point for Stout. Back back down to the sideboards for Robinson. Moves to the faceoff circle, shoots. Now decides to pass across to Godfrey. That was a play that was working so well against Minot. Now Hughes carries the puck back to the blue line, but now passes across to Robinson. Robinson in front, and Eunice got his pad on that and directed to the corner. Now Godfrey back behind the net for Palmer. Palmer back behind the net for Robinson. Robinson looking out front, now gets into the high slot area. He'll shoot, rebounds loose, and Eunice makes two stops that I don't think he had any business making whatsoever. A new power play unit out. Saylor, Pashaya, Shane, Coleman, and Stout. Puck all the way down the ISO, which is 13 seconds left. Ali just rifles it away from the forecheck, but puts it right on the stick of Waterleck, who bumps into Stout. Now Coma in his own zone, which is 4 seconds left. Now Coma decides he wants to try and stick handle out, but he's taken out of the play by Waterleck. Now the Bobcats are in Fernie territory, and they're back at full strength. The shot, Ali makes the stop, and he'll just hang on. So the Riders now 1-for-4 on the power play. Off the faceoff. Puck is tied up in skates. Now the Bobcats take over. Back to the point. Vesely winds up for a shot, but it's off a skate. Goes to the corner. Allen comes off the near boards. Puck taken behind the net by Murphy. Murphy being bothered by two Bobcats. Just gets up to Popadich. Now Popadich gets it to the blue line. Downey put it up to the middle for Shane. Shane tries to get around his man. Shane falling. Gets a bad angle shot with one hand on his stick. Now Popadich taken out of the play. Downey back to the point to Murphy. A shot. Rebound lying loose in front. They score! But I'm not 100% sure on that one. Actually, Popadich gets the goal. I thought it might have been Downey's goal, but Popadich on the year. He's only been here for a couple of games, but already has two goals and an assist. So that's his fourth goal on the year overall. Second as a Ghost Rider. Now Downey plays the puck off the boards and out. Gets up to Popadich. Popadich carries up over the blue line with two men catching up. Gets it to Shane in front to Downey, and the play is broken up in front.
Hey, how many goals
did Brent have in Great Falls too?
Four minutes, 49 seconds left in this second period. Riders up 3-0 on the Bismarck Bobcats. This is the same lead they had against the Minot Muskies last Sunday night. Ali out of his net, plays it around the boards. Wasmuth tried to get it out of the zone. McLeod stepped in front of a shot from the point. Now the Bobcats look to get another opportunity as they dump in the corner. McLeod turns around, fires it off the boards, behind the net. Kissick off the sideboards now. Now Wasmuth breaking down with McLeod. Across to McLeod, a shot, they score! Ryan McLeod! Posse, keep your cool, Posse, and they're going to get the only penalty. That is Mark Wasmuth's first point in about 29 games or more. And is he happy? Look at him. Good for him. I love Mark Wasmuth. On the year, though, Ryan McLeod with his fourth goal. That goal coming at the 15:39 mark. See if that doesn't jumpstart Mark Wasmuth. Riders, more importantly, up 4-0 now. Robinson at center. Bobcats down 4-0. Robinson fakes the shot, goes around his man. Another shot on net, though, and Eunice knocks it down. Stout tried to keep the puck in at the point, but it was pushed out. Now the play kept in, though, as Stout banked it off the glass high. Robinson got it out front. Hughes was stayed high, though, and couldn't get a good, clean chance at that. Now Wagman back battling with Halverson. Wagman behind the net, still battling with Halverson, decides to push it to Stout. Now Stout has to deal with Halverson on the forecheck. Now Connor Hughes breaks up ice. He's got Palmer and Robinson catching up. Hughes taken out of the play. Nice play there by Matt Erickson just to take the man out of the play. Erickson from behind his own net. That was Townsend trying to pass up through the middle, and Stout tried to whack it back down ice. Wagman has to go back after it. Chased behind the net by Tom Erickson. Connor Hughes will have lots of time with the puck, and he just sends it out through the middle. Now 2-on-1, Palmer and Robinson. Palmer in over the line to Robinson. Robinson ridden out of the play by Townsend. Stout nearly had his stick lifted as Waterleck was coming in on him. Now Waterleck just plays the puck to the middle where it was a shoot in. Now the Riders bring it right back the other way. Robinson just flips it into the corner. Riders will look to make changes here. Saylor comes on. Now Coma comes on to join him. That means Pache is right behind him. Now Murphy played the puck to the blue line. Now here's Pache catching up to the puck behind the net. Coma back pass to Pache. Brings the puck out of the corner. Stick handling along the far boards. Pache grabbed onto. Now a shot from the point. Just went wide. Coma trying to pick up his helmet, but can't get a hold of it. Now Coma gets his lid back on. Riders out of their own zone. Saylor had the puck go off his shin pad, but he was behind the center line when that happened. Jakub Coma upset there was no penalty call on that play when his helmet was taken off. On the faceoff, wins the draw. Robbie Godfrey couldn't get back to the puck, though, as he was ridden out of the play by Halverson. Halverson goes into the corner. Back pass to Wiggins, taken out of the play by Coma. Wiggins still on his feet. Puck out of the corner. Now a penalty being called against Coma. Bobcats control, but Godfrey touches it. And that'll be a cross-checking call against Coma. Didn't look like a cross-check to me. It looked more maybe like a rough, but or an interference maybe, but not a cross-check. And Mark Palmer on the penalty kill. Wagman takes off the faceoff and rings it around the boards. Puck gets out over the line. Palmer couldn't get to it as he was battling with his man at the blue line. Now Palmer at center. Nearly collides with Halverson. Halverson cross-ice pass to Waterdeck. He gets in over the zone. Back pass to Wiggins. Wiggins with a shot, but it was well wide. Now Halverson battling along the ice for the puck. Wagman ends up with it, though. Puck back to the point. Now sent into the slot area for Wiggins. A shot. Ali's down. And they score.
Bismarck Bobcats first goal scored, power play goal scored by number 7, Ryan Wiggins, with assist number 21, Brent Halverson, and to number 4, Kelly Reimers. Time of the goal, 18:52. Last minute of play in the second period.
So the power play goal scored by Ryan Wiggins. On the season for Wiggins, that is his 24th goal on the year. Riders with possession though in the Bismarck zone. There's 40 seconds left in the period. Popovich put it behind the net for Shane, who got it out front, but Downey was peeling the wrong way. Now Popovich battles in the corner with his man. Riders with good momentum to answer that Bismarck goal. Now Popovich just pins the puck up against the boards, but it's dug free and Downey ends up with it. Really good effort here by the Ghost Riders to match that goal. Now the puck sent wide of the net by Murphy. Downey to Shane behind the net, 11 seconds left, now out to Godfrey. Godfrey puts it back out front. Eunice makes the save, 5 seconds left. Now a penalty. Right at the end of the period, a penalty is going to be called. Sticking. Not sure who's going to get it. But after two periods of play, the score is Fernie 4, Bismarck 1. Underway. Brent Halverson takes the puck off the faceoff and shot. Ali got a piece of that. Shots after two periods of play are 26-23 in favor of the Ghost Riders. Both teams currently 1-for-4 on the power play. Alex Stout plays the puck off to Mark Palmer. Palmer bats at it but can't get it out past the forecheck. And now the puck squirts up and into the crowd. Had the puck go off his stick. Robinson wins it cleanly, back to Stout. Stout gets across ice to Wagman, who skips it out past Vesely down the ice. Back in his own zone is Dave Scott. Scott behind the net, starts things out. Carries up over the blue line, but puts it right on the stick of Stout, who sends it back in, looking for Robinson, but it was knocked down by Vesely. Now back out to Stout. As Stout and Vesely play pass back and forth, just inside and outside the blue line. Now Robinson looked like he might be able to take the puck, but it's taken off him, and Halverson brings it to center, just flips it in. Riders get the puck to the blue line. Hopping inside the line now, they finally do get out. It didn't look like it was going to get out of there, but Connor Hughes got just enough mustard on that. Now the Bobcats break in, though. Ali makes one stop, and puck is pushed to the corner off the rebound. Now the Riders chip it down the ice. Bobcats back to pick it up. Icing waved off. Coma into pressure. His man, puck all the way down the ice. Icing waved off. Posnikov rips the puck around the boards. Pashea gets it out. Coma swiped at it at center, but it was controlled by the Bobcats. Now kicked back to the Fernie line. Godfrey, cross-ice pass for Pashea. Can't take it off his skate. Now Eunice plays it away from Coma, but Saylor's in there to get into the fray, but the puck just shot straight up and out of the zone. Now Pashea off the backhand gets it back to the Bismarck line, but the Bobcats get it back out to center. Dump it into Fernie territory. Ali off the boards, up to Saylor. Saylor near side, takes a hit. Can't get the puck past the blue line. Now Vesely shot, and Ali will hang on. So the Riders facing down a 5-minute major penalty here to Jared Saylor for spearing. Bobcats trailing 4-1. So it's a slashing penalty. I was told it might be a spearing penalty, but a slashing penalty. I haven't seen too many five-minute majors for slashing in my lifetime. Bobcats circle back in their own zone. Half a minute gone in the power play now. Up over the line. Andy Allen brings it through center, in over the line on Godfrey. Allen stops on the far boards, winds up and shoots. Puck went off a skate or off of a leg. It was Jim Murphy's leg, and he's limping a little bit. Ryder's already down a man, and now one of their defensemen limping. Sent behind the net now. Townsend couldn't pick it up. Puck come free for a second, but now the Bobcats control again. Cross-ice pass, shoots. Wide is Andy Allen. Now Murphy. Tried to get control of the puck, but he was pushed out of the play. Murphy still limping. Townsend plays it to the sideboards. Now a one-timer in front. Ali made the stop. Actually, I think it hit Mark Palmer. Connor Hughes hammers his man. Hughes hammers Andy Allen. What a collision there, and Connor Hughes won that battle. Now Coma hammers his man. Ryder's doing a good job on the penalty kill. Ryan Wiggins goes back after his man. He's going to get a penalty for it. Wiggins is going to go to the box, and that's just a bad play by Wiggins.
Wiggins, 2 minutes for a guy sticking. Time of the penalty, 3:47.
So it's 4-on-4 for the next 2 minutes, and the Bobcats back to the power play for a minute 14. Still a major penalty, so they can score more than once on that power play if they can. Townsend, cross ice, looking for Erickson. Now back to center, Halvorsen. Halvorsen behind the red line, just dumps the puck into Fernie territory. Pashea off the sideboards. Coma can't pick it up. Puck swept off his stick. In the faceoff circle, Halvorsen still with that puck, and he's a one-man puck control relay out there as Wagman reverses his field behind the net to Alex Stout. The puck is sent all the way down the ice. It'll be an icing call on the Riders. Fernie territory, 15:26 left in the third period. 4-1 Riders lead. Off the faceoff, Posnikov carries behind the net. Pucks up to the line, Vesely. Tried to keep it in, but McLeod turns on the afterburners, and he'll get a shot away. Wozma goes cruising towards the net, but the rebound went the other way. Love to see Wozma score in this game. He's already got an assist. Now Cullen, cross-ice pass for Posnikov. They get into the Bismarck zone via the dump-in. Now McLeod behind the net, takes a bump. Cullen, now we're going to see a fight between John Rudnick and Jake Posnikov. Posnikov takes a couple of shots early, now tries to come back, but Posnikov's the man that goes down. Off in Bobcat territory.
5 minutes each for fighting.
Robinson behind the net, tried to get it out front. Puck still loose. Now Hughes picks it up. Back to the point for Murphy. He'll get a shot on net. Kicked out by Eunice. Dave Scott carries the puck in behind the net. Pass for Paulson. He missed it. Hughes bumps him off the play. Now a hit by Robinson. Robinson pushed down after the play. Now Godfrey steps away from a hit. Robinson comes in on his man. Robinson chasing Dave Scott behind the net. He'll come out the other side. Bobcats look to start up. Just 6 seconds left in the even situation, and the Bobcats will have a power play. puck running around the sideboards and chipped out by Robinson. Icing waved off because it's a power play for the Bobcats. Connor Hughes chases his man behind the net. Now Jakub Koma comes in.
Get him!
Riders forechecker's doing a good job of keeping the Bobcats from getting out cleanly. And that causes some confusion at center. Now Pashaya kicks the puck up to his stick. Pashaya out front to Koma. Just put the puck wide on the deflection. What a move by Pashaya as he was going to overskate the puck but kicked it to himself. And now Ali makes a stop on the long shoot-in by Wiggins.
Program number 2266. That's 2266 for a free movie rental from Gone Hollywood. For a gift certificate from Kelsey's Restaurant.
Townsend off the faceoff in the offensive zone. Puck jumped out past the defenseman. Now Jakub Koma in on his man. Andy Allen spins away. Pashaya will chase him down. Allen peels back to the point, just leaves the puck behind the net. Pashaya runs into his man. Now Stout pokes it out. Jakub Koma chasing it down. Gets around one man. In alone. Koma scores! Short-handed again! Jakub Koma, two short-handed goals! So the Bobcats get a 5-minute major, and they're scored on during that 5 minutes. Jakub Koma's second shorthanded goal of the night has made it 5-1 now. Jared Saylor set to come back on in 26 seconds. And that is a load off Jakub Koma's shoulders. Let me tell you, he's been frustrated because he hasn't been scoring, but two shorthanded goals tonight will bring him back around. Just 19 seconds left in the major now, 5-1, Riders lead. They get it out of the zone. Just 13 seconds left in the major now. Bobcats start out of their own zone. Palmer sends them right back in. That should kill off the penalty, just 3 seconds left. Bobcats get up over their own line. Saylor back into the play, a long shot in, wide of the net. Wesley keeps the puck in at the far point. Riders converge on the point man, though, and end up with the puck. Connor Hughes looks for the breakaway pass, but it's knocked down. Now Wagman carries the puck in over the line. Now Connor Hughes steals the puck. Try to put it back out front, but all the Riders were headed the wrong way.
And number 10, John Sanja.
Cullen gets a shot. That's off the goaltender to the corner. Kyle Shane chased his man down and got it back to the point, but not out. Now on second effort, they do get it out. The Bobcats do through center. Godfrey backhand pass to Downey along the far boards. Downey just lifts a high backhand in. Popovich nearly pulled down as he tried to get in by Andy Allen. Now Popovich out of the corner. In to help out is Downey. Gets it to Shane in front, and Shane can't get it in. Can't get the puck in. And down! Robbie Godfrey! On the long rebound, and that is Rob Godfrey's fourth goal in his last four games, and that makes it a 6-1 lead for the Fernie Ghost Riders. The seventh goal of the year. This is payback for the trips to Bismarck when the Bobcats controlled the Ghost Riders from start to finish. How does a 6-1 lead grab you? Assist should go to Kyle Shane on that.
Ghost Riders, six goals scored by
So Kyle Shane does get the only assist there on Robbie Godfrey's seventh of the year. Off the faceoff, Ryan Wiggins goes to the far boards with the puck. Robinson ends up with it, though, pushes it towards the blue line. They can't get it out. Ali makes a stop, pushing the puck into the corner. And after that is Halvorsen. Now the puck out front. Nice job of tying up his man, though, is Ryan Cullen. Now off the sideboards, Hughes plays a pass out to center for Palmer. Palmer looked for Robinson, who was sneaking up, but couldn't quite catch up to him. Wiggins fell as Robinson went through him. Now Cullen chased back in his own zone. Jason Asadourian in hot pursuit, but the puck comes back along the sideboards to the point, though. Ali is down as the Bobcats hammer away at it, but .55 left in the third period. 6-1, the Bobcats trail.
We got Brendan. It's Brendan's birthday out there. He's sitting over in the Wild Punch section. It's Brendan's birthday. Brendan, stand up. It's his eighth birthday. Happy birthday, Brendan.
Change here for the Bismarck Bobcats as Tom Fortunat is going to go into the nets. He's got a 4.00 goals against average in three games for Bismarck, a 3.64 goals against overall, 5-12 record with an .886 save percentage. Bismarck captain Keith Townsend say 10 minutes left to send a message. We hope this doesn't degenerate. Heard one of the players, or one of the coaches actually down there earlier saying, we have more talent than this Fernie team, let's take them on. But I guarantee you right now, they don't have more scoring. Now here they go, Pashaya to Sainer. What a save by Fortunat. Now Murphy right back down the ice. It'll be an icing call as Jan Pashaya, very, very unselfish player. Likes to set guys up, likes to pass the puck, but has scored some key timely goals this year. Right now, though, he's lost his stick. Sailor pushes it to the sideboards. Pashaya continues to battle very, very strong and holds the puck up against the boards. Jakub Koma not too far behind. Koma very speedy as well, but when Pashaya cranks it up, can he ever wheel? Very strong lower body. Now a shot. Ali kicks out it or hit the crossbar. One of the two. Now Koma.
Go, 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 go!
Sends the puck out of the zone. Just saying about Jan Pashaya. Very strong lower body. And when he gets that stride going, he is gone in a hurry. He's got afterburners and then some. Now the Bobcats behind the net look to get the puck out front. Popovich intercepts it, though, and just chips it out over the blue line. 9:41 left in the third period. 6-1 Riders lead. Goals in this period by Jakub Koma, his second shorthanded marker of the game, and by Robbie Godfrey, his fourth goal in the last four games. Now Tyler Wagman pulled down. There's going to be a penalty called here. Bobcats control it. Adam Kostichka in his
time of the penalty at 10:30.
Bobcats slam the puck down the ice. Kyle Stout back there. Takes a bit of a hit from behind, and he's looks like he might be shaken up a little bit. Now McLeod tries to get it out. Second effort, he'll be able to. He'll just skate back in his own zone, though. Looked like he was going to try and head for the blue line, but now he'll just stick handle out of his own zone. Now through center. Hits Downey with a pass. Gets across ice to Cullen. Cullen from a bad angle. Shoots on net. Unfortunately, makes a very weird save. Now McLeod trying to set up Wasmuth. Puck stopped in front of the net, though. Now Wasmuth at the point. Try to put it back in the slot area for McLeod. Puck just trickles to the corner. Bobcats try to get it out, but Wasmuth is on him quickly. Now Downey back to the point to Cullen. Cross ice to Godfrey. Godfrey fanned on it. That might have been a blessing, though, as he's got the defenseman down now. But now the Bobcats able just to fire it down the ice with 55 seconds left in the power play. 8:23 left in this third period. Now Cullen out from behind his own net. Plays the puck up to Robinson. Robinson, he'll carry in over the line. It's a cross ice. Hughes fanned on it as he tried to get a hold of that bouncing puck. Now Palmer, sideboards to Robinson. Robinson, down low to Hughes out front looking for Palmer, but Fortunate got a piece of that and he'll just hang on. Now Hughes, back to the point to Bechea. He falls. Let's see that skating that Bechea is now, but he falls again. Now Godfrey comes in after Waterleck, a shot, and Ali makes the stop. What a... Off Bobcats barely keep it in. I didn't think they did, but they did. Now Saylor and Shane breaking over the line. Saylor to Shane, just put it over his stick as it was a bit of a saucer pass off the ice, about 2 inches. Now about 3 seconds left in the power play. Godfrey from behind his net to Pashea, back to Godfrey. Godfrey with 7.5 minutes left in the third, just rifles it around the boards. Shane won't go after it. He'll change him up. The puck sent all the way down the ice by the Bobcats. Icing waved off. Murphy to it first. Dumps the puck off the boards, out over the blue line, picked up there by Jason Asadourian. Asadourian sends the puck back inside of his own zone to Bo Jack. Jack with a high shot over the head of Ali. Now Coma looking for Hughes. But Hughes couldn't catch up to that pass. Now in over the line. Bobcats looking to set up Halverson in front. Now Coma taps it past the defenseman. Palmer's out on the ice as well. Hughes nearly picked off that clearing attempt. Murphy, first man back onto it. Sent the puck to Palmer. Now Robinson with Hughes catching up, a 2-on-1. Robinson and Hughes, Connor Hughes couldn't pull the trigger, and Tom Fortunate made 2 stops there. And he was fortunate that Connor Hughes didn't get a good wood on that. Now the Riders, as they touch the puck, are going to be called. Connor Hughes for the high stick, I think. So a power play for the Bobcats. 6:12 left in the third period. Now off the faceoff, puck back to the point, now set up in front. Wagman tipped it to the corner though. Waterleck looking for somebody out front now. Spins away from Wagman. Waterleck, bottom of the faceoff, circle far side. Sends it behind the net for Halvorsen. Back to the point. Bobcats look to set something up. Halvorsen in the faceoff circle. Everything closes up in front of him, so he decides to go for a skate down the sideboards. Dumps it off to Waterleck. Waterleck tried to get it in front. Puck is loose. But the first man there was Stout. He couldn't get it out, though. Banked it off of Waterleck's shin pad, but couldn't get it out. Matt Erickson keeps it in. Now down to Waterleck behind the net for Halvorsen. Halvorsen dumped the puck in behind the net for Waterleck. Puck off the side of the net, I think, there. Erickson keeps it in. Down to Halvorsen. Halvorsen will tee it up and shoot. Ali got a piece of that and sent it wide. Now Halvorsen to it first in the corner. Minute 4 left in the power play. Another shot. Ali makes that stop. Now Stout tried to poke it past Halvorsen and does. And now Robinson gets it all the way down the ice. 4 brand new penalty killers will come on. Bobcats out of their own zone to center. Koma bumps his man. Knocks him to the ice. That gives Pashaya a clean breakaway. Pashaya in alone, unfortunate. And put it high and wide. Nearly another shorthanded goal there for the Ghost Riders. 4:42 left in the third period now. McLeod stepped on the ice, and he'll skate on the puck first, rings it around behind the net. Townsend takes a bump from Koma. Puck back to the point, though. Ali made the stop, kicked it to the corner. Godfrey plays up to Koma, and Koma golfs it down the ice and takes a hit after the play. Now 8 seconds left in the power play, 4:20 left in this third period. And a two-line pass is going to...
It's program number 2444. It's 2444. Program number 2444. Winner of the Diamond Ring, sponsored by Jay's Jewelers.
Wasmuth heads into the corner. Puck taken away by Paulson. He'll skate up ice. Gets it past Kissick. Cross-ice pass. Connects with Kostichka. He'll dump it in. Ali just lets it go wide of the net. It bounced to the side. Picked up by the Bobcats. They got the possession in Fernie's zone. But a pass through center. Picked off by Kissick. And it went through Wasmuth. Now back the other way in a hurry as the Bobcats. 2-on-1. Godfrey. And Ali makes a nice stop. And Joey Jamal Ali is underneath one of the Bobcats in Riders off the draw. McLeod wins it cleanly to Cullen. Cullen finds a streaking Mark Wasmuth. Wasmuth tries to get around Vesely. Now pushes Vesely into the corner hard. Wasmuth got the best of that collision, that's for sure. Now McLeod pulled down to the ice afterwards, and Vesely's going to take a penalty. There's 6 Ghost Riders out on the ice right now. So they straighten that out. Kyle Shane, Jared Saylor, Jakub Koma, Jan Pashaya, and Alex Stout out on the power play.
Broadcast number 27, Mike Waterman. 2 minutes for roughing. And the penalty, 16:32.
So they call a penalty on Waterman, but it's actually Vesely. Saylor bumps his man off the puck. Puck comes back to the point to Pashaya. Down low to Shane. Shane back to the point to Stout. Stout with a shot. Kick to the corner. Now Koma has it, looking for the hat trick. Koma shoots, and Fortunat makes the save.
Friday and Saturday, those 2 days.
Face off now to the blocker right hand deep in Bismarck territory. Tom Fortunat off the draw. Puck back to the point. Stout has it blockered into the corner. Now Townsend. Well, that's Halvorsen, rather, goes after it, sideboards. Puck kept in at the point by Pashaya. Now Shane, back to Pashaya, moves into the middle of the ice, trying to get it down low for Koma. Now Shane off the sideboards, down low for Koma in the corner. Koma spins away from the forecheck, switches places with Kyle Shane. Off the sideboards now, Jakub Koma, back to the point for Pashaya. Puck out front, and a shot from a sharp angle, and Fortunat kicks that out. Left in the third period, a minute left in the power play for the Ghost Riders. 6-1, Fernie leads. Connor Hughes back to the point to Stout, down the sideboards to Hughes, back to the point to Stout, but he can't. Oh, does keep it. I thought he was going to have it pushed out past him, but now Hughes looks out front for Godfrey, who was sneaking in back door. They had some success with that play, but not this time. Now Godfrey knocks the shootout down at center. Now here comes Robinson. Robinson sideboards. Cross-ice pass for Godfrey. He'll take the one-timer off the boards, but doesn't shoot it. Decides to pass instead, and it goes off a skate. Picked up there by Jason Asadourian. Brought up ice. Two-on-one against Stout. Asadourian shot. Ali makes the save. Now he'll just hang on. Alex Stout plays the puck behind the net. Coming all the way across his corner, he used to try and make a play on it, but it was dumped in behind the net before he could arrive there. Now Wagman just watches it go by him out to center. Tried to make a play on it as well, but Palmer ended up trying to make the play after all, and Palmer ends up throwing his weight after going through a bit of a rough stretch. And the Riders are slowly climbing back up in the standings. Goaltending very, very, very important in junior hockey. Important everywhere, but especially in junior hockey where the scores can get high. Fortunat kicks that one to the corner. Pichea, as the team's back at full strength. Stout knocks the stick out of Vesely's hand. Now the Bobcats bring it in. A shot from a bad angle. Ali makes the stop. Didn't know where it was. It's on the other side. But the puck was cleared away. Now the Bobcats look to bring it out front off a skate, and Saylor ends up with it. Now a penalty coming up. It's going to be Kostichka, it looks like, or Wagman. Pichea on the draw, wins a faceoff, and Cullen knocks it up and out of play, but it's off. Off the draw, Bobcats control. Kelly Reinhart sends it to the blue line. It's off of a man, though. Now Townsend brings it in. Now Pichea with the puck in his skates. Picked out of the feet by Townsend. Now Andy Allen gets the puck in front of the net. Poke check by Ali and a rebound, and they score.
Mark Bobcats' second goal, a power play goal, scored by number 20, Kate Townsend, with assist to number 15, Josh.
For Townsend on the year, it is 26th.
Andy Allen, time of the goal.
Now the Bobcats up the far side for another shot on net. Ali, watch that go wide of the net. Now bodies flying everywhere in the offensive zone. Bobcats look out front. Another shot, and Ali comes up with a great stop. And the rebound is cleared up over the glass and out of play. Now Kyle Shane, Popovich, and Downey out to finish off this period. 13.8 seconds left. Now Downey dumps the puck in, wide of the net. Bobcats, first team back to touch up, but Popovich got back there to throw a hit. Now with just 1 second left, shot comes in from a bad angle, and Ali doesn't have to make the stop. I know he didn't want to let that second goal in. He would have much rather seen this game end 6-1, but it is a 6-2 final. Watch the Bobcats get it from the fans, none, no doubt, as they come off the ice. And that'll do it for this hockey game. The final score, Fernie 6, Bobcats 2. Ghost Riders go 1-4 against Bobcats all year.
6-2 win. Coulda, should have been 6-1. It would have been nice to see Joey keep it to one goal, but he's back. He's really playing well again. A couple of those long shots. I made a comment during the game. I think when we were in Bismarck and Minot, that's when our goaltending was really struggling. Billy and Joey were both struggling in that time. And a couple of shots from outside the blue line, I think maybe two of them in one game, beat him cleanly. And I'm not sure if there was any of that left over from Bismarck, but when they saw Joey have trouble with the one shot, they started shooting on him from long range again, and another shot hit the outside of the net. I'm not sure how dangerous that one really was, but shades of maybe what happened on that trip, but Joey settled right back in again, didn't let it bother him, and the Bobcats figured out we're not going to score him from outside the blue line.
Oh, no way. Especially like if you watch the Ghost Riders practice, they do a lot of long shots on both Billy and Joey Ali, and just to keep them aware, try to control the rebounds. Again, it was a packed house tonight, Everybody witnessed a fantastic games. The Aussie section louder than ever. And what can you say? The boys worked hard. They came out flying, and they didn't stop. They played a good, solid game. Bismarck came at us at first 10 minutes and attacked us hard, but we didn't crack. We still kept on going. And what can you say? Jakub Kolma gets out of a slump with two shorthanded goals. Huge.
I don't think it's any secret when you watch the game. I was concerned in the first 10 minutes. I thought that Bismarck maybe carried the physical play, maybe had the better skating legs, but we did match that. It didn't take us long to match that, and when we did, we just took off with the game. I'm not sure. I mean, it's hard to say that because after one period, only 1-0. But I think really until about the 12-minute mark, we didn't match Bismarck's intensity.
No. And another thing I have noticed, too, is when the opposition comes into your arena, they come at us flying at first 5-10 minutes. Try to break us, try to crack our shell, as if you want to speak, and try to take the crowd out of it. Teams know now, when they come into this arena, they got to take our crowd out of it, because we're so close to the ice, the fans can say anything they want, they can make a ton of noise, and the thing is, the players hear it, and when you're standing on the ice and you look up, it's intimidating, big time.
1-for-6 on the power play. So Fernie continues to get about a goal a game on the power play right now. Good clip. Yeah. But they've allowed in the last four games, if I can do a quick calculation in my head, I believe it's 5 power play goals. They did have the number one penalty kill on home ice, but now they've fallen behind Bozeman. I don't think that's a big concern right now because it hasn't cost them a game yet, but it's something they're going to have to address in their own barn. Are teams getting used to playing on the smaller ice surface? You hope not, because that was a wild card the Riders had, was keeping opposing teams off the score sheet on the power play.
Yeah, and also the teams now are also crashing our net. They know that in order to get that puck into the net, and everybody knows it, you look for those rebounds, and it could be just maybe a half a foot in front of Joey's glove or Billy's glove. You have to get it, and that's what our goaltenders are there for, to grab those rebounds, and our defense is supposed to clear the zone. Be aggressive, get them out of there, and protect our goalies at all time.
I think another key, we talked about this before the game, it could give them some momentum heading into that big road trip. I mean, the game against Bozeman, we talked about the beginning of the game, might as well mention it one more time. It's obvious. It puts points between Bozeman and Fernie. But those two games against Billings could very well, and at this point, I wouldn't be at all surprised if they did come after us in the first round. We've talked about that for the last little couple months here. And the Riders have to do something to give themselves some confidence against the Bulls. Although a couple of those games, you got to look back on a couple of those games, and luck was on Billings' side in a big way for a couple of those contests, most recently especially, but they got to break the goose egg.
Yeah, that's for sure. And one thing, we would like to get into that top four position, because I'm not exactly sure, but I don't think the top four teams can battle each other.
No, because it'll be home ice.
Yeah, so if we can get a top four spot, Billings will have to look for somebody else. Again, there's Kimberly Dynamiters, a strong opposition, Bozeman Ice Dogs, strong opposition, and Bismarck too. But I'm positive Minot's going after them big time, without a question. It's only like an hour and a half, 2-hour drive from Minot, and you want the shortest possible distance between one another as well. But again, Riders, when they get ready and go on the next road trip, go and get that win out of Billings. Shake them up, let them know, hey, you're still playing around with us, and if you want to beat us, you got to come back here.
Even one out of two games in Billings, to take one of those two games in Billings would be huge. But you know, that's an interesting point. I want to find out about that. I think you're right. I don't think one can go after four or two can go after four, because you've earned home ice advantage.
Yes. Yeah.
So it's pretty hard to do that. Maybe, I don't know, but maybe they give it to the team if two comes after four. Maybe they give home ice advantage to two. But I think the top four teams are guaranteed home ice. I'll have to double check on that. But what you said about Kimberly is very prudent, because if Kimberly loses to Bismarck tomorrow night, we're back to three games back of Bismarck. Bismarck burns one of their games in hand, though they're no longer three points up with three games in hand, or 3 points up with two games in hand, and Kimberly would stay 4 points ahead of Fernie. So we're within striking distance of fifth and fourth place all of a sudden. Like I said, I'd almost root for Bismarck in a scenario like that, so that we can keep a little bit closer to Fernie, because I wouldn't want to see Kimberly go back up by six at this point, because it's going to be a tough road trip next weekend.
Oh, for sure, and you can't take anything lightly. If anybody that's seen a Bozeman Ice Dog game on our television from Bozeman, you get 3,500 fans into that arena. They're loud. They're just as crazy as this, maybe a little bit more, just because of the overwhelming support that they do get. It's a big arena, big ice surface, and they go crazy. And they got an announcer that feeds the fans and get them riled up. Billings is also another big arena. If they can file in 2,000 people, 3,000 people, that can make a difference as well.
An old WHL arena.
Yep. And people have to remember, fans are a big importance. They can be the intimidator without a question, and the idea is just to try and phase them out. That's easier said than done.
Bozeman doesn't have a great record on home ice. Billings does have a great record on home ice. That's Bozeman. I mean, Billings away from home is not that strong a team. They've come in here and beaten us a couple times, but away from home they're not that strong. So we'll see what we can pull off next weekend. But for those of you watching this game tonight, we will have all three of those games for you on Elk Valley Radio. I will bring all three of them to you from Bozeman, Billings, and Billings. And as we said, if we can win two out of those three games, that would be a key road trip. And I think we'd be set for the rest of the season as far as momentum goes. But back to tonight's game for a second. They dropped the goose egg against one team. Yes. Only one team left to beat in the league now, and that's Billings. They've done their job against Bismarck. If they do happen to meet in the playoffs, you just plant that little seed of doubt. No longer can Bismarck say we're 5-0.
Yep.
And now they need to do the same against Billings. We already talked about that. No sense talking about Billings anymore, but good effort tonight. The guys really skated hard from start to finish, and you said it earlier, Jakob came out of his slump. Yeah. Jan was just flying out there tonight. And I made a comment on tape. I'll put every cent I have in the bank on the fact that he's the fastest guy in this league.
Yeah, I think so. And like that one play when he was on the point and the puck popped by him, and that Bismarck player had at least three strides to him, and Jan was at a dead standstill and caught him.
Fell down, but he caught.
Yes, he did. And that proves what kind of skater this young man is. You gotta remember, he's 6'1", 190 pounds, everybody. He's solid, he's big, he's strong, and he's actually gonna make a real acquaintance and really make Billings or whoever we have to play next week that, hey, if you give him space, look out, he's gonna burn you.
One thing we had going for us when the goaltending was struggling a little bit was all of our goal scorers were scoring. Yeah. Connor was scoring a lot of goals at one point at the same time as Jakob was, and Jan was chipping in. We had about four or five guys going at one point. Now Jakob was in a bit of a slump. He came out of that. Connor's point streak ended tonight at seven games. Jeremy Robinson extends his, though, 14 points in his last eight games now. And when everybody isn't scoring, it's nice to see the goaltending step up now. So we're in good shape right now. If you got one or two guys scoring, the goaltending is there now. And if you've got all four guys scoring, the goaltending doesn't necessarily need to be there. You'll win games like 6-2. Yeah. So I think we're in good shape right now. And I think we could make a serious push for fourth spot. Third might be a bit tough. We're 13 points out of third. But fourth spot, I think we can make a serious push for.
And you got to think, Brent Popovich, Kyle Shane, each got points tonight. That one goal from Popovich was a beauty, right through the five hole. Ryan McLeod scores, assisted by Wasmuth. Right down from top nine, right down to the fourth line, we're getting scoring and defensive well. You gotta like that, especially coming at this time of the year. If it keeps on going, and I said before, if we can improve our power play by 5%, yeah, that's not much, but 5% could actually make a difference by the end of the year. From, say, 11% up to 18, 19% and getting into the playoffs, that's a confidence boost that really opens up a whole kettle of worms. They could score from the point. They could score on defense. They could score on offense. It's a major confidence boost.
And we're getting goals from our blue line. Rob Godfrey, four goals in his last four games. Well, that'll wrap it up here from Fernie tonight. Final score, 6-2 in favor of the Ghost Riders. Todd Jones always comes in and come in and say something if you're going to laugh at us.
He just make fun of
us. Now he's gonna pretend he's quiet. Here he comes into camera now. We can put Todd in our post-game show, can't we? Come on in. Your thoughts on the game.
I actually thought I was real happy and real proud of the guys. I thought they worked. Sorry about that. I'll stay in the camera. I thought they worked very hard. I thought this was probably the best we've competed in. You know, all year for 60 minutes. I thought we played, and it was a team effort from the back end out. Everybody had a very good night, and I couldn't ask more of the guys. I just real proud of them, and our composure was very good. They were taking some tens and things like that. And I thought we held our composure very well. So again, hopefully this is just another, you know, building block. And again, I couldn't be more proud of the guys. They worked their butts off, and as a coach, that's all you can ever ask of guys. You know, they play hard and they play smart. And I thought our guys were put on a good show for the fans. And again, you know, I know our guys get pretty riled up with you know, the fans that come in, and especially some of the Australians and I think Kiwis and all the other nationalities that come in the rink. I know all the boys would probably, you know, if they were on the camera, let's express their thanks to them, because it certainly charges the boys up. And no matter what, they're always cheering for us, and we appreciate that.
I won't keep you very long, because we've been talking here quite a bit, Sean and I. But I got to ask you about, you were talking to me for a good month about defensive zone coverage. That started to show up, and now you've won three of your last four.
Well, again, it's just, you know, every team goes through its ups and downs, and a lot of times it happens in January, and I think that was, you know, it's just a matter of getting refocused, and, you know, I think that's what's happening. And again, you know, like you talked about defensive, you know, that's just more of a mental state of mind, and guys have done a very, very solid job back there. And again, it's just a matter of, you know, believing in yourself and believing in your teammates, and, you know, and then just down to hard work, because you know as much as I do, is the defensive side of the game is the toughest part of the game to play, because it demands so much, you know. And offensively, things start to click for you if you're taking care of the defensive end, and that's what's been happening. So hopefully, you know, every team's tough in this league, and you have to show up to play 60 minutes. So hopefully, we just keep, you know, keep improving, and then, you know, again, just keep working hard.
That's head coach Todd Jones, and final score tonight, what was it?
I believe it was 6-2.
Get us out of here. Good night from Fernie.
Good night from Fernie.